Nothing fancy this week. No green screens, no 3D modelings of micrometers, no Python code, and perhaps most notably, no conclusions. This week, I just want to talk about some observations that I've had recently about the way my brain regards the differences between work and play. In my 15 years as a software engineer, I cannot remember a single time that I coded just for fun. I never picked up an IDE and tried to create something just because it would be cool. There were the occasional extracurricular startup attempts, things of that nature, but never just for fun. In the same way, I was a photographer and taught photography at a summer camp for 8 years. And during the summers, I lived through the viewfinder of my camera. And the second the summer was over, I took basically no photographs. But notably, during one of the winters, I was at a friend's birthday party. It was a house party. And she asked me to take photos of the guest, you know, kind of document the event. And in that instance, something clicked in my head, and suddenly I went from uninterested in taking photos to being all-consumingly driven to perfectly document the event. I was running around getting people together for group shots, taking candids, and I basically experienced that entire party through the lens of a camera. And these two examples are not the only ones. In my life, it seems that I can see a very clear delineation that I have subconsciously drawn between work and play. And during my playtime, I don't do things that are work. And during my work time, I don't do things that are play, with the possible exception of the occasional game of foosball or ping pong on company dime. This pattern seems strange to me. I don't really understand where it came from, but most recently, as my job has changed, I've noticed a lot more instances where my classification of something as work has driven me to do it in a way that previously I had been unable or incapable of. The two examples that spring to mind are the Python code that I wrote for automating thumbnail generation and the 3D model of the micrometer that I made for the video 2 videos ago and then spent all of last video talking about. And for those of you who watched the last video, you'll remember that I made a point of how long I had access to 3D software and basically done nothing with it. The Cliff's Notes version of it is, for 20 years, I was fascinated by 3D software, and in that time, I did little more than render an occasional sphere and never really use it for anything meaningful or really learn how to use it. And then, rather enigmatically, that 2 decades of wishing that I knew how to model in 3D in 2 weeks became part of my job. A thing that I felt that I needed to do, and I mustered the motivation to learn and do that thing. End of note, it didn't feel like work. I had certainly classified it cognitively as work, but it was fun. I enjoyed it. I look back fondly on having done that. Speaking more broadly, it feels a little bit like my new job, making these videos on YouTube, has opened up the possibility of me to work on a whole bunch of things that I have long considered cool, that I wanted to do, but that I lacked the motivation or initiative to do until they were classified as my job. I kind of think of this as surrendering to that part of my nature. I accepted that the only way that I was going to learn and do all of these things that I wanted to do was to make them officially my job, at least in my head. And I know that this isn't universal, because people have hobbies, right? I could have very easily continued being a software engineer and taken up amateur filmmaking as a hobby. But I've had very bad luck with hobbies in the past, and I'm very curious as to why that is. But where this gets really strange, confusing, I don't know how you would want to describe it, is when we talk about going in the opposite direction, when we talk about play. I've been pretty open on this channel about the fact that I'm a big fan of video games. I think that they are an incredible opportunity to share an experience, do something cool, learn a new skill, all in kind of a controlled and entertaining environment. And video games are something that I have played in one form or another since the early 90s. During my free time, that was one of the things that I was always excited to do. But then last November, I did something weird. I made playing video games part of my job description too. I started my Twitch channel and I started playing 20 hours of video games a week, 5 hours a night, 4 nights a week. I turned one of my hobbies into a job, officially, at least in my head. And it's clearly changed my relationship with video games. Now, for the most part, outside of those 20 hours a week, I have no interest in video games. Whereas previously, if we're being honest, sometimes they might have consumed more than 20 hours a week. Now I feel very sated, very content with the amount that I am playing. And strangely, if I ever decide to play video games while not streaming, I generally now still hit the record button and create exclusive for my YouTube gaming channel content. So in a very strange way, I have truly converted the video game playing that I was already doing into something that I treat very much like work. And this is where we get to that conclusion that I revealed earlier I didn't have. The observation is that it seems like classifying things as work that I want to do seems to give me purpose. It motivates me to actually do those things that I want to do, whereas over the course of years, I might never do those things if they did not end up in that conceptual bucket in my head. And I'm not sure if this is a relatable condition or something that is kind of strangely unique to me. It feels like it exists somewhere on a spectrum between dysfunction and life hack. Dysfunction in the sense that I feel like I should be motivated to do the things that I want to do. If I want to learn video editing, I should just learn video editing because it brings me joy and it's a thing that I want to do. And life hack in the sense that it seems I've cracked the code on how to create motivation for myself to do the things that I want to do. I can simply say, well, that's work now, and I will suddenly find a whole new trove of energy and enthusiasm for doing that thing. And that's about as far as I've gotten with the thinking on this one. I'm super curious if these concepts seem familiar and interesting to you or foreign and weird, but I don't know that I have anything else to share right now on it. I just wanted to throw these ideas out there and see what other people thought. So for now, as always, thank you for watching. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your week, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Not a Potamus. Ponderous.